In today's video, we're going to learn about the structure of an atom. And so by the end of it, hopefully you'll be able to understand atoms and their structure and a few other bits and pieces that go along with that, like how to draw a diagram and so forth. To understand what an atom is, we first need to understand what an element is. So an element is a pure substance that cannot be broken down into more simple substances. For example, water is not an element. It is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. Therefore, water can actually be broken apart into more simpler pieces. It can be broken up into hydrogen and oxygen. But hydrogen and oxygen cannot be broken up any further. They are as separate or as simple as they can get. And so hydrogen and oxygen are both elements. We can find all of our elements on the periodic table. Now, an atom is the smallest possible unit of an element that we can have that still maintains all of the properties of that element. And when we say smallest, we mean like teeny tiny. So like 0.00000002 meters in diameter, teeny tiny. Everything in the whole universe is made up of atoms. Now, atoms are tiny, but they are made up of even tinier parts that we call subatomic particles. There are three types of subatomic particles that an atom is made up of: protons, neutrons, and electrons. All atoms have a nucleus. This makes up the center of the atom, and the center of the atom is made up of protons and neutrons. Protons are the largest of our subatomic particles, and we say they are equal to one atomic mass unit, or AMU. Protons are positively charged, and I remember that P equals P, so proton equals positive. The number of protons an atom has gives that atom its identity. For example, all atoms that have 8 protons are of the element oxygen. All atoms that have 3 protons are of the element lithium. This number for each atom is represented on the periodic table of elements, and it's called their atomic number. No other type of subatomic particle has anything to do with the atom's identity. Only the number of protons determines the type of atom that it is. The other type of subatomic particle that makes up the nucleus is called the neutron. Neutrons are neutral particles, meaning they don't have any charge. They're not positive or negative. I remember that N equals N, so neutron equals neutral. The mass of a neutron is about the same as a proton, and so we also just say that it is one atomic mass unit. Neutrons are super important in the nucleus because they actually stop the protons from repelling each other. Since protons are all positive, and we know that like charges repel, a nucleus of only protons would not exist. It wouldn't be able to hold together because the protons want to repel each other and move away from each other. Having the neutrons in the nucleus allows the protons to stay huddled together in the nucleus without repelling as they're broken up by the neutrons. The only atom that doesn't have neutrons in the nucleus is hydrogen, and this is because hydrogen is only made up of one proton and therefore it doesn't need the neutrons to separate the protons. The number of neutrons is not always equal to the number of protons. To calculate how many neutrons are in an atom, we need to look at the atom's mass on the periodic table. We then subtract the number of protons from the mass, since they are all one atomic mass unit. And that will give us the number of neutrons present. This is because the mass on the periodic table is made up of the number of protons and the number of neutrons. Now, electrons are the last type of subatomic particle. They are very small, about 1/1000th of a proton. And they're so small, in fact, that when it comes to calculating the mass of an atom, we actually regard electrons to be equal to zero. We don't count their mass because it's so minuscule. Electrons are negatively charged particles, and since atoms are normally neutral, the number of protons and electrons are usually the same. Electrons are not part of the nucleus of the atom. Rather, they move around the nucleus in what we call orbitals or shells. The number of orbitals an atom has depends on how many electrons are present. The periodic table helps us to determine this, and I'll go through this soon. But first, let's look at some examples of atoms so that you can get a full idea of what they look like altogether. So here I have the new Google Interactive Periodic Table. It's actually really cool. If you're a student or a teacher, you should definitely go and check it out. I'll drop the link in the description for this video. And it actually has an augmented reality option if you're using it on your iPhone. So awesome. So you can actually have all these different atoms in the classroom with you if you want to. But let's get back to looking at some examples. So here we have hydrogen. Hydrogen has one proton, it has no neutrons, and it has one electron. And we can see that here. Now, if we move across a period, so the periods in the periodic table are your like horizontal rows. Okay, so here helium and hydrogen are in period number one. If we scoot across to helium, we can see that the only thing that changes is the number of protons and neutrons and electrons. And what I mean by that is that you can see there's still only one orbital for the electrons. Okay, so helium has two protons. Let's have a look at the neutrons. It's got two neutrons and it's got two electrons still in one orbital. Now, when we go down to the next period, period number two, this is where we get an extra orbital. So lithium here, lithium has three protons, it has four neutrons, and it has three electrons in two orbitals. And if we continue going across in period number two, okay, this one, beryllium, we can see here that still, again, the number of orbitals is the same. So it's got two. And if we keep going across, we'll see it's still two, still two, still two, until we get to period number three. Now, we're in period number three, and we've got three orbitals there. One, two, and three. So the period number actually gives you the number of orbitals or electron shells that are present for those atoms. Now let's consider the groups. So the groups are our vertical columns. So here I've got hydrogen. This is in group number one. Lithium, also group number one. Now it does have a different number of orbitals, but there is something that's the same between all of them. Group number one, sodium. Have a look at the valent electrons. So the electrons in the outer shell, potassium, still group number one. Now the thing that's the same between all of these atoms is that they have one electron in the valent shell, in the outermost shell. All down group number one, they all have one valent electron. We go to group number two. They all have two electrons in the outermost shell. Now I'm going to jump over the transitional metals here. I'm going to go over here. This is group number three. Three electrons. Group number four, four electrons in the outer shell. Group number five, five electrons in the outer shell. Group number six, six. Group number seven, seven. And group number eight, they all have a full octet of electrons, except for helium, but it still has a full outer shell. So helium has two. Here we have a full octet, full outer shell for neon, full outer shell for argon. And these are called our noble gases because they're unreactive because they already have a stable state of being because they've got a full outer shell of electrons. I hope this video has helped you to gain an understanding of the structure of atoms and being able to use the periodic table in order to help you to decide that structure and to be able to identify those patterns as well. If you like this video, please hit like below and make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any upcoming videos.